Díaz, ¿no? Y también este crítico de cine de Nuevo Día. Él va a estar moderando el Q&A con nuestro gran amigo Maximiliano Hernández.
Tú eres Maximiliano, para ti no hubo que pedir el Q de que aplaudieran, así que estás en buenas manos. Ok, pues yo precisamente voy a... La intención es de poder iniciar el diálogo con Maximiliano para entonces rápidamente pasarle a ustedes la oportunidad de hacer las preguntas para que no me estén mirando así como que esa pregunta no está bien, así que yo la hubiera hecho mejor que él. Anoche precisamente cuando estaba como que un poquito de revisando para... porque sabía que iba a hacer esto, estaba chequeando los rumores de... hay una superheroína de Marvel y están hablando de esta cuestión de que ya fue una actriz a Marvel Headquarters y le entregaron los cómics. Cuando hay una especie de inicio, una vez tú entras al universo de Marvel y te asignan un personaje, hay una especie de ritual iniciación, ¿o qué pasó cuando tú sabías que ibas a hacer de ese juego?
No, bueno, lo que pasó conmigo fue bien, bien raro, porque la verdad es que si uno se parece así, no es latino, uno es pelón.
Ajá.
Es alto, tiene el pelo rubio, you know, y yo de niñez yo leía todos los paquines, todos los comics de Marvel. Y yo sabía quién era Sewell, y una amiga mía que era la directora de casting, y ella empezó con Marvel, hizo Iron Man, y ella fue que verdaderamente luchó para Robert Downey Jr. porque, you know, como tenía problemas en el pasado, no querían aceptarlo así tan fácil. Y ella dijo, you know, I want to bring you in for, you know, for Kenneth Branagh. Kenneth Branagh está dirigiendo la película. Y
La primera Thor.
Y me dijo, you know, I want to bring you in for Sitwell. Y yo dije, Jasper Sitwell. I said, okay, yeah, I'd love to, you know. So entré, fui a la audición, leí. Y ese mismo día, ella había mandado el tape a Kenneth, que estaba en Londres. Y lo vio, y él mismo llamó de nuevo y dijo, you know, ¿cómo es de persona él? Y dijo, él es un, you know, actor bueno y que trabaja duro y llega, you know, es un, you know, he's a good guy, you know. Y así mismito dijo, ok. Y así fue como pasó. Me encantaría decirle que es un larga
cosa. Like,
oh my God, and I had to audition and do this. And no.
Okay, pero para, to give him an idea,
yeah,
that's an anomaly.
That
as
so
a working
weird.
Actor.
It never okay. happens. Especialmente en una película así de grande que, you know, my agent is here too, and he'll test you. Can, we'll go, you know, you'll go can be considered for a movie, and you know, a veces hasta se me olvida que yo fui a audicionar por la película. And they'd be like, oh yeah, you're doing that movie. I'm like, which movie? Like, I completely forget that I did it because that much time has gone by. Y pues, eso nunca pasa así de rápido, que ahí mismito, el mismo día, ya tenía mi día, bueno, welcome to Marvel. Y trabajé en el Thor primero, y después de Thor, que yo y Clark Gregg lo decimos amigos, y cada vez que trabajamos, digo, Max, stand right next to me. Always stand next to me. Y me dijo, he said, I want you to be in this movie as much as you can. So me agarraba y me dijo, I want you to be. And then, después de hacer eso,
sí, bueno, los cortos, los one shots.
Lo hicimos, lo llamó el presidente de Marvel.
Kevin Feige.
No, es el otro, Louis Desposito.
Okay, there you go.
The co-president.
There you go.
So Louis Desposito me llamó y me llegó un número como raro en el teléfono. Que yo no sabía que entraban las letras también. You know, like, it was like, no, it was like 70Z. You know,
Barry Shield,
you know. And I was like, what is this number? I pick up and it's the co-president of Marvel. And he said, hey, you know, we have this idea. We want to start doing these, like, short movies to put on the Blu-rays, like, just bonus footage and stuff like that. Y, you know, extra para ponerlo en el DVD. Y yo dije, okay, está bueno. Y él empieza a explicarme la película, the first one shot. But he does it, like, como un fanático. Y después... va a ser esto, y después va a ser esto, y va a ser, y this is the president of Marvel, y tienen una energía que yo nunca he visto así para un presidente, algún, you know, un que tienen tanto poder ahorita, especialmente en Hollywood, con esa energía, y ellos conectan todo, conectan las películas con el show, con los, you know, con los comics, con todo.
Pues precisamente una de mis preguntas es, porque antes había esta cuestión de la división entre lo que es televisión y
sí.
lo que es cine, tú
sí.
tienes la experiencia de ser uno de los actores junto con Clark Gregg, este
sí.
que básicamente une ese universo con Marvel. ¿Hay una diferencia, tú notas algún tipo de diferencia en términos de valor de producción o la experiencia de producción, independientemente de que estás haciendo el corto, el show de televisión o el feature?
Yo, bueno, la maravilla que han hecho Marvel, han traído mucha de la gente que trabaja en producción, all the effects guys, they'll bring them over to consult, para que, you know, there's a sort of a uniform look to it. El problema que yo he visto con el show, que no tiene la misma calidad de la película, porque es de
el presupuesto y el tiempo de televisión.
Uno tiene, ellos, creo que ellos filman un capítulo en 7-8 días para un capítulo. Y eso es rápido, eso es bien rápido. And they have to do effects and they have all the other parts of it. So you're not going to have the same level, you know, of quality. But everything that goes through Marvel for the TV show is connected to the movies. They all sit down, they have meetings and say, all right, we're going to do this, y esta película va a salir en abril o en agosto, en lo que sea, y ellos están completamente preparados en cómo van a empujar el show, porque quieren verdaderamente, yo creo que han tenido tanto éxito en este show, porque todo comunica, todos se comunican, todos se llaman, todos, you know, say, hey, vamos a hacer esto, entonces tenemos este actor, y lo que hace es it improves the cohesiveness of everything, because you have an idea, like everyone knows, you know, they do, and they all go to see each other's stuff.
Okay.
You know, so when I did S.H.I.E.L.D., when I was doing episodes of S.H.I.E.L.D., they go, hey, saw Winter Soldier.
But actually, but
and it's like that, and then I'm like, and then I say to them, like, what happens in the next episode? You know, like, I want to know everything that happens, and everyone wants to know.
Esa era mi próxima pregunta, porque obviamente cuando tuve la oportunidad de hablar con el actor que hizo de Bucky, then he's the Winter Soldier.
Sí.
He says he didn't know until the last minute if he was going to go and be the Winter Soldier. So how quickly did you know that you were gonna, that your arc on the S.H.I.E.L.D. show was going to toss you to the Winter Soldier on the big screen?
I knew. We had already shot Winter Soldier.
Okay.
Yeah, and then there was talk of, all right, well, we want to pull him and lo queremos poner en el programa de televisión también para conectarlo todo, pero yo no sabía en qué capacidad iba a ser completamente.
Okay.
So I figured it was going to be deep. It was, you know, they're going to go, and I didn't realize that till I got the script, the last one, where I go like, you know, I got to catch a boat. Mm-hmm. And that's when I realized, wow, they really connected it directly. Because mm-hmm. the next scene in the movie is they're going on a boat.
You're going on a boat.
Yeah. and I'm pissed off and I'm tied up and like, pissed off. You know? And it's like they literally made those choices because they wanted it to be. I think it's really smart. And I think it's because I think they're thinking of TV in a new way.
Mm-hmm.
Because they say, okay, we don't want to be, we want it to be all one big universe, Marvel. And they have, what, almost 80 years of comics, of storylines, of villains, of everything. You know, unfortunately, they lost some of their properties, you know,
yeah.
When the Marvel Comics was, you know, barely making it and they were like going for bankruptcy, they had to get rid of Spider-Man, mm-hmm. which, you know, Sony has, and X-Men, which Fox has, and, you know, and unfortunately, Fantastic Four, which I wish that all that, and they wish it too. That's the one.
Why unfortunately, since we're in a room where I know they'll appreciate your feedback. On
I mean, I, you know what's funny is I, come on, it's like that first movie was god awful. It was like a god. That was a god awful Fantastic Four. That was, and I'm a big fan as you guys are. Trust me, I've been reading comics.
Did you tell Evans that when you were on the set?
No,
you know that movie you did. That's,
yeah.
That was god awful.
It was bad. He, when you look at him now, I mean, there could be no other Captain America for him.
Of course,
it's
yeah.
like ridiculous. But back then, I was like, wow, it's like this is really.
I got an interesting question, given the audience, el público que tenemos aquí, que son gente apasionada de Marvel y
no,
de
todo. Aquí.
Así, no, bueno, nada. No, bueno.
No.
Precisamente, como alguien, como un actor latino, que se apropió de un rol que era rubio y Caucasian y todo demás.
And it had a six pack.
Exacto.
I have a keg.
Por you know, y después de la medalla, pero anyway, hablamos de eso después. How do you feel about the new Johnny Storm? You can't go into a chat room without some people genuinely upset the fact that we have an African American.
You know what? I'm a big fan of Michael B. Jordan. Mm-hmm. I think he's a really good actor. I think it's a really brave choice to go that way. And if they're gonna reboot something, like now at this point, if you're gonna reboot it, like really reboot it. You know, like now I hope if they do a reboot of Spider-Man, I hope they do the Miles Morales storyline, because I think that people would be like, I think everyone would say that that's like the coolest thing to go that way, and it would completely open up that universe, you know, to it. But yes, I said unfortunately the Fantastic Four.
You didn't pick out.
Yeah, but you know what? But they, what's funny is they think about those things. Like they just got back Blade. Marvel got back Blade. They got back a lot of properties that they're very like. You know what? We could do this again.
Which other one are you really passionate about?
Which one? The one that I think should be made. I think Black Panther.
Yes. Yeah.
I think that is such a huge. I mean, if you think about it, I'm a big Black Panther fan. I'm also a big Namor fan, and I think like you know a Submariner movie would be an amazing. But Black Panther is such a great mythology. This whole, I mean, he's not only a champion, he's a warrior, he's a king. You know, so it's like you can really build that story.
I mean, you've been showing up to work with Black Panther t-shirt just throw it out there or something.
At the San Diego Comic Con, my son, you know, I was on the panel, and my son comes up to the microphone. I'm like, oh my god, it's my son. and then they grab the microphone, and I'm sitting with Kevin Feige and Luis Esposito. And then I go, he comes up, oh my god, it's my son. And they're like, oh my god, okay. And they're like, Diego, you can ask anything you want, anything you want. And he's like this, okay, I'm going to ask this question because my father told me to ask it. But why isn't there a Black Panther movie? And when will there be a Black Panther movie? And then they said, Diego, come over here, we're going to tell you a secret. And they invited him up on stage and they whispered in his ear. And then people were like, what did he say? He's like, I can't. He's like, it's so cool, I can't tell you. And then I said to him, what did they say? And he's like, I can't tell you. And he held over the Hail Hydra thing to me. He's like this. He's like, well, you didn't tell me about Hydra, so I'm not going to tell you about Black Panther.
Antes de empezar con las preguntas del público, obviamente una de las cosas que da muchas discusiones es la diferencia entre cómo se desarrolla el universo en las novelas gráficas y cómo lo que se hace en las películas. Mm-hmm. Obviously, Sip comes back after, you know, it's not the Winter Soldier that kills them after the Hydra thing.
Was that even Sitwell?
Is that an open door?
The reason I know it's in the chat rooms is because I feed the chat rooms all the lies. But I'm surprised at how much things pop up in chat rooms that you think that, oh, that can't be true. And I'm like, after I've read the script, I'm like, oh my god, that's totally that's totally right. And I gotta like pretend that I don't know what's going on. But no, I mean,